The new fallout in the ISIS attack that killed four American soldiers in Africa.
The White House is being pressed to explain what went wrong as it defends the president's phone call with the widow of one of the soldiers who died. A Florida congresswoman is standing by her characterization of that call, saying the president didn't seem to know the dead soldier's name. The president, meanwhile, has called Frederica Wilson's claim a complete fabrication.
At the same time, one key senator is saying the White House isn't doing enough to explain what exactly happened to those heroes on the ground.
This morning, a team of military experts looking into how U.S. troops were ambushed by dozens of heavily armed ISIS fighters. Four Americans killed in that attack 2 weeks ago. The body of one, LaDavid Johnson, wasn't found for 2 days. Hundreds of troops are in Niger as part of the war on terror. And the Pentagon wants to know if military leaders missed warning signs. Another person asking for answers, Senator John McCain, the chair of the Senate Armed Services Committee. McCain claims the White House is not being upfront about what happened during the ambush.
Is the president satisfied? He knows everything he needs to know about this particular raid.
I don't think that the president can ever be satisfied when there's loss of life from men and women in the uniform.
The incident already raising the potential prospect of a Benghazi-like investigation. You recall when Congress looked into that deadly attack on a U.S. consulate.
This is going to be Mr. Trump's Benghazi, because there are so many unanswered questions, and that's the only conversation I want to have with the President of the United States, the only conversation.
The administration also facing criticism over how it first announced the troop deaths in Niger. The White House confirms a condolence statement in the president's name was drafted hours after the incident, but it never went out. Instead, Press Secretary Sarah Sanders chose to make a statement in the briefing room the next day. The president did not mention the fallen American soldiers for 12 days.
The new fall-